So if we had to look at these four terms over here, we might be tempted to try and factorize, or take, or so not factorize, but do a common factor and take something out. But there's nothing that is common in all four terms. However, when you see four terms, you should try and think about the technique called grouping. What grouping means is you typically choose two of them at a time. So for example, if you had to choose these two terms, is there anything common in those two terms? Well, yes, they both have an A. And if you had to look at the last two terms, spot anything that's common? Yes, they both have a B. And so what you can do is factorize each part separately. So in the first two terms, we'll take out an A, and then what would we have left? Well, in the first term, you would still have an X, and in the second term, you would still have a Y. Then, what are we going to factorize out in the next term? A B, right? But what, a positive B or a negative B? Because what I often see students do is they do something like this, and that's not correct. You have to specify, are you taking out a positive B or a negative B? Well, let's take out a positive B. Then, what do we have left in term number one? Well, that's X, and in term number two, that's Y. Now, if we look at these two terms, which is this one over here and this one over here, can you spot anything that's common? Aha, X plus Y, and X plus Y. So we take that out in the front, like this, and then we open up a bracket, and what would we have left in term number one? Well, it would be this A over here, and then what would we have left in term number two? Well, it's this positive B, and that's the answer. So let's try this technique now with this question. So if you had to try to take out a common factor out of all four terms, well, that wouldn't work, because they don't all have a common factor. But what we could try and do, and sometimes your first choice won't work out, but let's choose the first two, because I can see, well, we can see that they definitely have a common factor of X, and then we can choose these two over here, which have a common factor of Y. And so if we take out a common factor of X in the first term, on this first part over here, well, in term number one, you're still going to have another X left over, and you're going to have, this X is not going to be there, so if there's nothing left over, you just put a 1. Then, what are we going to take out in these out of these two? Well, they're going to have a positive Y. And so then we open up a bracket, and what would we have left in this term? Just an X. And what would we have left over here? Just a positive 1. Can you now see the common factor of X plus 1 and X plus 1? If you do get a common factor over there, then you know you've done the correct step in... Well, you've done the correct method in step number one. So then what we do is we take out that common factor of X plus 1, and then we'd be left with this X and this plus Y.